sounds like good to everyone. Now let's continue with constant velocity problems of vector. Like velocity is a quantity that has both magnitude and direction. The magnitude of velocity is speed. Okay, if speed, if velocity equals to 5i minus 6j meter per second, then find speed. So, how to find the speed? Okay, because of velocity is magnitude of speed. That means, okay, so let's say v equals to 5i minus 6j. Okay, because of speed equals to magnitude of velocity. Therefore, speed equals to v modulus. Okay, this is how we find speed from velocity of vector. So what do we do? Square root, okay, 5 squared plus negative 6 squared, okay, so equals to 25 plus 36 square root equals to square root 61 or cert 61. Okay, this is how we interpret determine speed from velocity. Okay, so next, you should already know the formula for for an object moving with constant speed. Okay, you always see this. Okay, so like s, right? S equal to, remember this formula, distance dt. Right. Okay, similarly, the formula for object moving with constant velocity is velocity equals to displacement over time taken. Okay, now if an object has initial position and move with constant velocity v, okay, the position vector r at time is given by the formula r equals to, r is position vector. Okay, position vector equals to r equals to a plus t v. A is initial initial position, t is time, v is velocity, constant velocity. Okay, question to discuss. Okay, let's look example number one. A car travel from point A with position vector 75i minus 45j km to a point point B with position vector negative 60i plus 22j km. Okay, so from here, this is final position and this is initial position. Okay, so the car travel with constant velocity and takes 5 hours to complete the journey. Find the velocity vector. Okay, so velocity vector equals to final displacement minus initial over time taken equals to by using matrix form, negative 60 22 minus initial is 75 and negative 45 over time taken, and then simplify, negative 60 minus 75, so we get negative 135. Okay, and 67 over 5. Alright, so what do we get? Negative 135 over 5i plus 67 over 5j, so equals to 27i, negative 27i plus 13.4j. Okay, so this is how you find the velocity vector if the question give you final and initial displacement. Okay, number 2, example number 2. Okay, this is the velocity. Okay, the time taken is 6 seconds. Right, find displacement. Okay, from the formula, we know that velocity equals to displacement over time taken. Okay, so velocity is 5i minus 6j. Displacement d, okay, the one that we want to determine, and 5 over 6 seconds. Therefore, d equals to, okay, 6 multiply 5i minus 6j. So what do we get? Okay, 30i minus 36j. So this is the answer by using this formula. Where do I get? Okay, from here. Okay, next example. Okay, a bus travel northeast. Okay, northeast with speed 32.4. Find the velocity vector of the bus. Okay, and then okay, first what do? We must draw. Okay, draw northeast. Okay, let's say this is north, and northeast is like this. This is northeast. Okay, so northeast. Okay, we draw right angle triangle. Normally is 45 degree between north and east. Okay, so this is, right, this is, let's say x, and the vertical we name is as y. Okay, so what do we do? We find x and y. X is for I, okay, xi, and vertical is yj. Okay, so that's why we must find x and y. Okay, how? By using the trigonometry, right? Cos 45 degree equals to adjacent, okay, adjacent x over okay, the speed of the bus is before I forget, 32.4 kilometer per hour. Alright, so over 32.4, and then rearrange, so 32.4 times cos 45 degree, and then you get 22.91. this is for x, and then let's count for y axis. So sin 45 degree equals to y opposite over 32 over 0.4. We arrange y equals to 32.4 times sin 45, so you get also y equals to 22.91. therefore, right, therefore the velocity vector equals to, right, 22.1 i plus 22.9 j. so this is velocity vector for this situation. And then number four, okay, number four, a plane flies on bearing 250 with speed of 80 meter per second. Find the velocity vector. Okay, from the situation we have also draw the diagram or sketch the diagram. Okay, this is north. Alright, and then from north, okay, the bearing is 250, so from here is 90 degrees plus 90 degrees, 180. Okay, and then we assume, okay, the 250 degrees is in this location. Okay, with speed 80 meter per second. Okay, and then what do? Okay, we draw the right angle triangle. And do you think, okay, what is the angle for color purple? Okay, so 200. Okay, this is, let's say this is 90 degrees, 180, and this is 270 degrees. Therefore, okay, the color purple equals to 270 minus 250 equals to 20 degree. So this is 20 degree. And then we name okay, the horizontal as x. Okay, as as x, and vertical as y. Okay, so find x and find y. Okay, so from here, cos 20 degree equals to adjacent is x over the speed of the plane. Plane is 80 meter per second, and then therefore x equals to 80 times cos 20 degree. By using calculator, you will get 75.18. And then for vertical, sin 20 equals to y over 80. Okay, y over 30. So therefore, y equals to 80 times sin 20 degree. And then by using calculator, you will get 27.336. Right? Okay, so therefore, okay, the velocity vector equals to 75.18 i plus 27.36 j. Okay, so that's all for constant velocity problems. Okay, now let's discuss, okay, the IGCSE examination question. Only one question. Okay, let's discuss. Let's start. Okay, a particle P is moving with velocity of 20 meter per second in the same direction 3, 4. Right, find the velocity vector. Okay, so to be clear, right, let's sketch the situation. Okay, this is P, right? P moving at 20 meter per second, right? And this in the same direction, which is 3, 4. Okay, find the velocity vector of P. Okay, so first step, what do we do is, right, find the unit vector in the direction. Okay, so first let vector A equals to 3, 4. Okay, therefore magnitude of A equals to 3 squared plus 4 squared square root. Alright, so you get 25 square root equals to 5. Okay, therefore, okay, unit vector in the direction of A equals to 1 over 5 3, 4. Okay, and then step 2, what do we do? Right? Okay, velocity vector of P, therefore velocity vector of P, so equals to 20 meter per second times with the unit vector in the direction of A. Okay, so equals to 1 over 5 times 3, 4. So simplify, so 4, right, 4, 3, 4. And then, so we name it as VP, and velocity vector of T, so equals to 12, 16. Okay, so this is the answer of velocity vector of P, VP. Okay, next. Okay, at times T equals to 0 second, P has position vector 1, 2 relative to a fixed point O. Write down the position vector of P after T second. Okay, so the position vector. Right, so position vector, we know the formula is R equals to A initial plus TV. Okay, so V is VP, okay, for P, right? Okay, so R, therefore R and position vector of P, okay, so equal to A is 1, 2 plus P times VP is 12, 16. Right, so again, A, right, A is initial position, right, V is velocity vector, and T is time taken, right? So this is the answer. And then next, a particle Q has position vector 17, 18 relative at O time T equals to 0 second, has velocity vector 8, 12 meter per second. Okay, given that P and Q collide, alright, find the value of T when they collide and the position vector of point of position. Okay, so the question asks you to find value of T when P and Q are collide. Okay, first we find the RQ. Okay, this is RP. Okay, question 2 is RP. So okay, from here, okay, RQ equals to, okay, position vector is 17, 18. Okay, the initial plus T. Okay, and the velocity vector of Q is 8, 12. Okay, and then we know that let's say this is equation 1, and RP equals to, okay, this equation of vector. Okay, so this is RP, equation 2. Okay, and then we know when they collide, so RQ equals to RP. Alright, so what do we do? We equate, so RQ is 17, 18 plus T 8, 12 equal to 1, 2 plus T 12, 16. Okay, so what do we do is okay, we take just only this, what I shared. Okay, equate. Okay, and you also can equate below. Right, so which one? Okay, so let's say I took the green color. Okay, so 17 plus 8t equals to 1 plus 12t. Okay, this is how you equate. Okay, the green, so rearrange to the right. Okay, so 17 minus 1 equals to 12t minus 8t, so rearrange, you get 4t minus 1, 16. So rearrange, therefore T equals to 4. Okay, so how about we try, okay, try purple, the purple one. Okay, so 18 plus 12 T equals to 2 plus 16 T. Okay, so why T? Alright, you have to expand, that's why you get 12 T and 16 T, as well as 8 T and 12 T. Okay, then rearrange back, so 18 minus 2, okay, and then equals to 16T minus 12T, so 4T equals to 16, therefore T equals to 4 also. Okay, so I hope you can understand, okay, and try more exercises, okay, until now, thank you.